it's Jules here, making a very exciting video today. And I actually mean that. It's not part of my persuasive script. Have you ever wondered how you can get your hand lettering or handwriting onto a computer and make it into a font? I make blooming videos on drawing, planning and publishing every Friday. So give me a huge thumb up down under if you want to go about seeing how this witchcraft is performed. It's not really witchcraft, don't switch off. You really can draw your own letters onto a sheet of paper, upload it to a website that will enable your computer to recognize it as a true typeface. And I'm going to walk you through every single step. The first time I did this, it was for my fourth book, Flossie Bonce. I just couldn't find quite the right typeface for what I wanted. So I started investigating, going about how to make my own. Turns out it's really easy. I've done it a couple of times and I've paid between $10 and $12 for it. And that means I've got my own typeface. Wait, hold on, roll it back a bit. Did I just say typeface? Well, yes I did. The word typeface refers to the family of letters, like Arial or Helvetica or Times New Roman. Font means what you do to that typeface, like make it bold or italic or lighter or condensed. So actually, when you're looking at some computer software, it should say typeface and not font in the drop-down menu. But someone, somewhere in the mists of time, made that mistake. So we're just gonna have to live with it. Oh well, just so long as you know the real difference. I have used a company called Your Fonts, typeface, and previously another company called DaFont. But there are loads of others to choose from. Your best bet is to do a Google search and review all the different ones that come up and make your own decision. I'm gonna walk you through how I did it with Your Fonts. Typeface. Ah. When you first land on the home page of Your Fonts, you see this page. It tells you it's a handwriting font generator, but it doesn't actually have to be your handwriting. You can make up a really cool typeface. If you need some inspiration, have a look at graphics that you already think look great, and then make one of those sorts of letters with your own spin on it. You can create the alphabet, both upper and lowercase, that's capitals and small letters, as well as loads of punctuation, numbers, and unusual characters that you just might need. Things like asterisks and at signs. Once completed, the font typeface can be used in every program that you own, so long as you upload it into your font manager. To start, you just need to click the link that takes you to your preferred template size and print it off. In fact, print two or three in case you need to make any changes or make any mistakes. Step two is to create your letters and numbers. You can enlarge the template that they supply and do your lettering on that. It's easier that way because it gives you more space. I've done two here, one on the A4 standard sheet and one on A3 that I enlarged on my printer. As you can see, all the boxes contain four horizontal guidelines. The baseline, that's this one, is where you would typically find the line if you were using lined paper. Unless the letter has a descender or a tail, like a Y or a G, the letter will sit on this line. The X height is the upper part of the letter, but not ones that have ascenders, like B or D. Those ones will ascend to the upper guide, like this. Make sure that you fill in all of the characters that you think you will need. I made the mistake of not filling in the numbers when I made my typeface for Flossie Bonce, and I can't tell you the number of times I've needed those numbers when using it. So fill in all of the numbers and most of the punctuation. If you don't think you'll need to use the euro sign or one of the Greek ones, then that's up to you. You ought to use a pencil to start with, and then when you're ready and you're sure you've got the characters right, go over it with a black pen. And then when that's dry, rub out the extraneous pencil marks. Number three, you can scan your newly made template into your computer and save it somewhere where you can find it easily, like on your desktop. There are more instructions on the page, but just remember to have a clean scanner bed, that the page is straight, and that you save the image as a GIF, JPEG, PNG, PDF, or TIFF file. At stage 4, you can name your font. This is what will show up when you have loaded it onto your computer, so make it memorable, but not embarrassing. Then click the box that says Choose File, and find the file that you have saved. Now press Upload. After a minute or so, it will have converted your sheet of paper into a preview of text, and at this point you can even write some custom text to see how it will look. Check to see if you are happy. If you're not, you can go back at this point and make new lettering on a different template. Remember those spares you printed off? You might need them. Okay, so if you're happy, click the download button and that will take you to the payment page. This particular company asks for PayPal payment. Once your payment has processed, you'll be taken to the install page. Follow the instructions here for your particular preference or computer setup. Once you install it, it should show up in your font book or folder or manager. Then just open up your software and use it. It really is satisfying to make your own typeface and actually get to use it on your computer. You might use it for graphic design for posters or for book work or for music downloads. And if you make greetings cards, you'll definitely want to use it for that. Next week, I'll be looking at how to read to a group of children, whether that's in a school or a library. And if you're a bookmaker, this is absolutely vital. Until then, I'm going to go and write to Apple about this whole typeface font fiasco catastrophe. I'll see you next time. Nanu nanu!